It's been a week since SpaceX's epic Starship SN10 landing, and then explosion after 8 minutes. And the company's already gearing up for another test flight. The latest Starship prototype, SN11, was rolled out to launch pads on Monday, March the 8th, at SpaceX's launching grounds in Boca Chica, Texas. Videos from SpaceX's website showed the towering SN11 rocket being hauled onto its launch site by huge cranes. Starship SN11 is the latest Starship prototype built by the private space company SpaceX for its massive Starship and Super Heavy rockets to take humankind to trips to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. Before this, on March 3rd, SpaceX launched its Starship SN10 prototype for a high-altitude test with some changes in its design. And these changes were successful in landing the rocket successfully. We've already made a video on the Starship SN10 landing and the major changes made to it, and we will link it in the description box, so make sure to watch it. Though the design changes helped Starship SN10 land, it couldn't sustain it because of another major failure and exploded in a massive fireball, just like its predecessors, SN8 and SN9. In this video, we will discuss about the recent changes that were made in the Starship SN11 and why we think it has the highest chances of succeeding completely. Also, we will take a look at the DearMoon project launched by Japanese billionaire Yusaku Maezawa, which will take him and 8 other passengers on a trip around the moon on SpaceX's Starship. SpaceX Starship SN11 and DearMoon project update. But why is Starship so important? Imagine a rocket that could launch and land 1,000 times a year. Sounds unbelievable? Well, that's what SpaceX is working on, the Starship. Its lifting capacity of 100,000 kilograms is more than any rocket currently in operation, and the whole system is designed to be reusable for frequent trips to space. It will launch atop a large booster called Super Heavy. Super Heavy will be the backbone of getting Starship and its crew on a journey to another world. The ultimate goal of Starship is to launch up to 100 people a time per flight. Previously, Starship SN10 made 2 significant changes. SpaceX realized that relighting 2 Raptor engines can also lead to failure, as Raptors are not fully matured yet and are still in the development phase. SpaceX realized that they can eliminate this by reigniting all 3 Raptor engines during the Starship flip maneuver. Starship SN10 was the first high-altitude prototype to perform 3 Raptor engine flip burn. The second major change in the Starship SN10 was the installation of a flight termination system, FTS. We have discussed them in detail in our other video. In the same manner, there was a significant change made in SN11. After SN10 recently became the first Starship prototype to successfully complete the high-altitude flight test in one piece and then exploded because of the malfunctioning legs. For almost a year, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has been talking about an upgrade in the landing legs and the challenges posed by it. So after SN10's failure because of landing legs, a new design for legs is a top priority. An interesting point to note here is during SN10's spectacular landing, at least 2 or 3 of the Starship's 6 landing legs failed to properly deploy, leaving the prototype with just half of the landing legs required to fully withstand the momentum of a landing. Starship SN10 didn't make life easy for the remaining legs either. At the time of touchdown, the prototype was traveling at 15 to 20 miles per hour, velocity much higher than expected. As a result of this, the Starship crushed those landing legs into oblivion, leaving the rocket more or less resting on its skirt section with no more than a few inches of ground clearance. About 8 minutes later, the prototype violently depressurized, producing a massive fireball as the remaining propellant flashed into gas and reignited. After the explosion, Elon Musk wrote on Twitter that even with all the landing legs deployed, the momentum during landing was way past the load the landing legs were designed to absorb, and the fact that only half of the landing legs deployed made the matters even worse. To refresh your memory, the first attempt of Starship SN10 was aborted with just fractions of seconds left in the countdown. The engines were ignited and ready to lift off, but then they were shut down when the computer on board detected too much thrust from one of the Raptor engines. Elon Musk wrote on Twitter that contrary to what flight computers measured, the thrust from the Raptor engine during the final phase of SN10's flight was in fact lower than expected, which ultimately caused the hard touchdown. Elon also added that the reason to why this happened is still unknown at the present moment. About 8 minutes after what seemed at the time as a successful landing, the prototype violently depressurized, producing a massive fireball as any remaining propellant flashed into gas and ignited. It's unclear if the post-landing failure was caused completely due to the hard landing or if there was some other technical issue also contributing to it. But regardless of the explosion, the flight test was still a spectacular and historic success for SpaceX, as flying a vehicle this big and then trying to recover it is a very hard task. At the same time, the failure of SN10 also sheds some light on the shortcomings that can be addressed with Starship SN11 and beyond. As mentioned earlier, SN10 used a new landing approach, relighting all three Raptor engines for the landing maneuver and step-by-step moving down to a single engine for touchdown. This new method proved almost completely successful. However, the still maturing technology of Raptor engines and the temporary prototype landing legs tells us that for the time being, SpaceX still needs to further refine the landing phase. These new designs are necessary so that the upcoming Starship prototype SN11 can be a complete success. After the failure of SN9, the SpaceX engineers switched to the three Raptor landing burn. In a tweet we mentioned before, Elon Musk added that for SN11, they are going to use two Raptor engines all the way to touchdown. And if any of the two Raptor engines underperform, the flight computer will instantaneously relight the third one to make sure the landing velocity remains low. As mentioned before, the major landing hurdle in the Starship SN10 landing was the landing legs, and this has been a major problem for SpaceX for a very long time. Elon has been talking about a need for the upgraded landing legs and the challenges posed by the seemingly straightforward goal of landing starships. After seeing the malfunctioning landing legs, a new design capable of significantly improving the reliability, stability, and toughness of the landing legs has likely become the major and topmost priority for SpaceX's Starship team and its engineers. As it turns out, a series of new official SpaceX renders released as part of an update for the DearMoon project may have revealed the latest glimpse of an updated landing leg design. A bunch of Starship new renders were newly added on the DearMoon official website. As you can see, these renders feature a Starship with outside-mounted landing legs. This updated design is reminiscent of an earlier landing leg concept released by SpaceX. The current landing legs used by the Starship prototypes were always made to be temporary, and after this intense flight, maybe it's time that Starship gets some powerful landing legs to stand on. Knowing how SpaceX works, it's also possible, if not likely, that these renders are already months old and one or several versions outdated. Either way, it's safe to say that significantly upgraded landing legs could start appearing at SpaceX's Boca Chica rocket facility anytime now. However, there might not be any major hardware upgrade for the Starship SN11. The major upgrade for Starship SN11 is the landing burn, which will now use two engines all the way to touchdown. With these upgrades made, there is high probability that SN11 will be the first Starship prototype to soft land after a complex high-altitude flight. Since the making of this video, Starship SN11 has already rolled out to the launching pad and begun ground testing. The prototype will undergo the usual cryogenic proof test and the static fire tests before eventually going for another high-altitude flight. From buying land spaces on Mars to building space hotels by 2027, people have been coming up with strange but interesting ideas. One more addition to this list is an exclusive invite to a private lunar expedition. A Japanese billionaire made an announcement 2 years ago in partnership with SpaceX to take 8 people from different walks of life on a trip to the moon. Since then, we haven't really heard much about the project, but that has recently changed. In a very recent announcement, Japanese billionaire Yusaku Maezawa made an announcement of a DearMoon project. As it stands right now, they are looking for 8 crew members to go to the moon. The pre-registrations were recently closed, and if you are someone who has a dream to go to the moon and have applied to this project, we wish you all the best. Apart from this, it will be the first civilian lunar mission to fly out past the moon, and as stated in the intro video by Yusaku, they will fly out past the moon to such an extent that it will be the farthest the humans have traveled. SpaceX owner Elon Musk too dropped in a message at the end of the video saying, "I think we'll make a real difference." SpaceX has made incremental tweaks and upgrades to its Starship design after each test flight, as it works to perfect the new launch system. The company has said that each Starship will be able to carry up to 110 tons to low Earth orbit. These Starships will help us fulfill our dream to become an interplanetary species. And the Dear Moon project is an exciting development for people, as it will be the first civilian lunar mission. So what do you think about the new landing approach of SN11? Will it be successful this time? Have you registered for the Dear Moon project? How will it affect us? Do let us know your thoughts and ideas in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel. And if you like the video, share it with your friends. It encourages us to keep making videos like this for you. Thanks.